Dear Tyler Perry, I pray that this letter meets you well. I've been meaning to write this for many years now and have finally built up the courage to do so. I know you probably get thousands of letters, so I wanted to write this in a special way so that you can see it. I first would like to say thank you. Thank you for coming to the aid of the Bahamian people in such a time of crisis and devastation. My name is Shanea Strachan and I'm from the island of Grand Bahama. For the past 2 weeks since the passing of Hurricane Dorian, I've witnessed the outpouring of love and support from people like yourself and many other international organizations like the Samaritan's Purse, the International Medical Corps, and many others that have fed us, counseled us, and taken care of us as we recover from the devastation of Hurricane Dorian. Love truly is the greatest force. Hurricane Dorian left a trail of destruction and destroyed many communities on Grand Bahama, one of them very near and dear to me. My roots are in the East End, and the settlement of High Rock, like many other communities in the East, was hit with a deadly blow. Lives were lost, persons are still missing, and many homes have been destroyed. One of them, my grandmother's house. Grammy's house hold many memories of my childhood, where I would spend summers and weekends exploring the settlement, playing on the bay, catching soldier crabs and getting into mischief with my cousins. Those are some of my memories of High Rock. We have been broken, but we will heal. I took this photograph last February of the lighthouse and was happy to see that the cross is still standing after the storm. Bahamians are strong and resilient people of great faith. And just like this cross, my faith in God will stand through life's toughest storms. It will not be shaken. It will not be moved. God is still good. He is still faithful, and He will reveal His glory. We will rebuild and rise as a people and a nation stronger than ever before. And that is my focus now, creating a new vision for Grand Bahama. One founded on faith, love, unity, and culture. The International Bazaar was once a popular tourist destination that provided hundreds of jobs for Bahamians, but it fell to the destruction of Hurricanes Francis and Jane and is yet to recover. One of my visions is seeing the 427-acre property turned into a residential community. I was happy to see that more than 500-plus Bahamians are in support of this, as I shared a post recently on Facebook that has gone viral. The abandoned property has been an eyesore and a refuge for the homeless for many years now, and I want to build a community that will not only provide shelter, but create jobs and preserve culture as well. A community with clinics, grocery stores, educational centers, recreational centers, daycares, and so much more. My next vision is to develop the film and television industry on Grand Bahama. Grand Bahama has a rich film history and was once the home to a 3,500-acre film studio where Disney would have filmed its Pirates of the Caribbean films. I would love to see the studio reopen to welcome film and television productions to the island. We have mass acres of land and natural sites that look like scenes out of a Hollywood movie. Grand Bahama is truly a playground for filmmakers. As a filmmaker myself, I know and understand the economic boost that the film and television industry pumps into an economy. It not only creates jobs, but it promotes tourism as well. And that is the vision that I have for Grand Bahama. I believe that the film and television industry will be the industry that will revive and restore the economy on this island. I've had this vision and passion for many years now, and my passion is burning now stronger than ever before. Today I work full-time as a production assistant in television. I am one of two females in my field, and as a woman I've had to fight to prove myself in this industry. I've met with persons of great influence to share this vision, and I will never forget their words. One asking the question, "This is great, but do you have a foreign investor?" And the second, "I like your passion, but you need a mentor." Sadly, it's never your own that believes in you first. With all the passion, knowledge, facts, insights that I had, no one has ever offered to be a mentor. Which brings me to this letter. Mr. Perry, I am in need of a mentor, a season to learn, to network, to build and to develop my team so that I can bring my vision to reality. Mr. Perry, you have inspired me from when I was a teenager, and I can still find books from when I was in high school with the titles of films that I wrote with the dream that would someday be produced by you. I've had dreams and hopes of one day working with you, and I hope that my courage and faith in writing this letter will open the doors to do so. I can't say thank you enough for coming through for the Bahamas. You truly are an inspiration and a hero. Sincerely, Shanea Strachan.